So it's really cool. I like going through my stash, and whatever I don't like, I just tell them, hey, let me exchange that. I also like to pick out what I'm gonna wear all week, and just enjoy the perks of being at the highest level, you know? It's important to stay humble, but it's very important to know where you're at, too. I crashed at about 11 o'clock because Coach Jones and Evan, they made me do a workout last night. I was ready to go to bed at 9, and then they called me and they were like, just come down, you'll feel better. And I'm glad I did, you know, I shed a couple pounds, and I sweat all that junk off in the airplane, so I'm glad they made me do it.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
What's on the agenda for the day?
Execute. No, we're just chilling. We don't have much. Trey, what do you got? Some media? You got some media? A lot of media. Superstar, Soukhamthath, sensational. We got MMA Junkie. He's got MMA Junkie. Nobody wants to talk to me. And get a sweat. Pull the trigger a little bit. And that's it.
This is the life, man. Nice vibe restaurant.
Is this all you do? You get hundreds of thousands? This is how you do it? You just rock the camera like that, Will? Where does the genius come in? Where does the genius come in? It's the editing, right?
Yes. We're going to do MMA Junkie radio show. It's going to be pretty cool because I've always been a fan of MMA Junkie, man. So we're going to the studio, and I'm going to kill this interview. I'm going to kill all my interviews today. I'm going to kill my food when I eat it later on. I'm going to kill my workout Saturday night. I'm going to kill the fight.
What took you down there? Was it family, the gym, or?
You know what? A teammate of mine, old friend of mine, Sean Soriano, he's also from Rhode Island. I was training up in Rhode Island at that time for a fight, and he had a fight. He went up to Rhode Island to do some training with me. He beat me up pretty good, so he was like, hey, he invited me down to train with the Black Zillions at that time about 4 years ago. And, you know, I took the trip. I moved in with him for about 2 weeks. You know, they told me to come back, and I went back home, fought about 4 times in 1 year, saved up, and came to Florida with a dream, with my wife, my son, a budget truck, all our things, and $2,000 in our bank account.
Wow.
But I really don't like Nissans. Just because I had 2 Nissans, and it kind of went to shit. But I do like Infinities.
Don't be sleeping on your level, cause it's beauty in the struggle, nigga. Goes for all y'all. It's beauty in the struggle, nigga. Yeah. It's beauty in the struggle, ugliness in the success. Hear my words and listen to my signal of distress. I grew up in the city and know sometimes we have less.
I get to eat in like less than 2 days. Friday morning, after Friday morning. Can't wait. I've been doing MMA when it really wasn't that popular yet. You know, when people still thought that boxing was better than MMA, things like that. You know, era of 11 to 15 years ago, when it just started blowing up. And to me, it's just a lifestyle, man. It saved my life. It saved my life. You know, when I was at the lowest point in my life, when I lost my son, the only thing that saved me was MMA, you know. Every day for like 3-4 years, I come home, my wife will come home, my girlfriend at the time, we just didn't know where we were at, you know, in life. What was our calling? What were we gonna do? But I know that I was heading this way, you know what I mean? And that's because of MMA. Every day I would go into the gym and just try to get better and better and better. And I just saw my career from the amateurs to the regional circuit to the national, now worldwide, you know, it just keeps getting higher and higher. And I just keep on reaching that next level because MMA kept me sane, man. You know, I could have turned to a lot of things, but I turned to MMA and definitely saved my life, man. It runs deep. It runs deep in my blood, my veins, and martial arts will always be a part of me.
Wednesday different from Tuesday, and you pick up your pace a little bit, or, you know,
I maybe slow it down a little bit. I don't know, it's probably the same shit really, you know. We'll see how the body feels, but weight's getting a little lower. But I mean, I don't really cut much, so.
When do you start to feel that energy really deplete?
Usually tomorrow. Once, yeah. Once I get into the 40s, you know. But again, luckily, I don't feel too bad because I don't kill myself with the weight cut.
Is there like a, after you make weight, like on Friday, is there like a certain meal you like to eat after, right after?
Nah, whatever my guy tells me to eat. It's usually after the fight, that's when I eat what I want to eat, you know? The fight ain't over, the nutrition part ain't over till after the fight. Then we will get burger, pizza, something shitty, you know?
UFC gym, UFC Performance Institute. Just finished with Steph. I'm gonna get started with Andre. Well, Steph gets the final preparations done with his physio team, and you guys miss it. Greg Jones and Steph went to war. It was like watching like a rhino versus a giant squid. That's how I best describe it. You know, Greg would have won if it was like not in a cage, but since it was in a cage, you know, he might have got strangled a little bit.
The last time I got my ass whooped, I was in the 9th grade, and my sister woke me up to go to school, and I didn't want to be up. And I was walking, and we bumped into each other, and she looked at me, and I looked at her, and we just went like that. And that's the last time, my sister.
Show that to his wife, I bet he's lying.
That flight got me messed up, man. Oh, and then my bet made
bed
it worse
last night?
Bed.
Yeah, that doesn't help. You're not a small person to fit in a crappy bed, to be honest.
I'm like, doesn't even, like, I flew first class, but I'm too big for those chairs too. So then I just, like, take a wrong posture when I fall asleep, and then I wake up and my hips are out of line.
Yep.
It's horrible.
Fast hips, athletic. Last one.
That's what we can now.
And up and shadow. Put a little pace in the shadow box now.
This is my ratio.
Back up.
She already hit like the flexor again. It's like, oh, dude, my back and my hips are tight.
Treatment today?
Loosening up his back and hips, so especially because of the travel and trip in, flying on airplanes and stuff like that, kind of get your low back and your hips super tight. So we're really kind of focusing on just getting everything nice and loose and feeling good for him to train and get ready for this weekend.
And myself, girl.
Those are in gun wikis.
Oh, dude. Francis, I know where he lives. I know where he lives, Francis. Don't worry about it.
And Gunnu gave him some hickeys. Look at those hickeys. God damn.
I know I got these last time at Wayne's, and woo, I'm addicted.
Yeah, I had a great workout. Hands feeling sharp. Rolled around with Greg a little bit. Get a feeling, you know, lungs opened up. Got a sweat going. Feeling great, you know. Just keep this up. Fight week, you know, it's a fight with yourself most of the time, and you just gotta stay calm and don't let that, you know, that fight in your head go the way your head wants it to go, you know, or you know, you really just got to control it, you know, control that anxiety and go in the cage and stay calm and just perform, you know.